Gene therapy, it is a one-time treatment using your own stem cells that are being modified outside your body through a genetic tool that will either remove or edit or add normally functional hemoglobin. After we collect your own stem cell, we send them to the lab where we have two different approaches. One is called gene addition, where we are introducing normal instruction of a hemoglobin that is functionally able to produce an adult-like hemoglobin. The second technique, it's called gene editing. Through technology and being able to be precisely targeting gene, we can target the gene that it is defected, and we could either make it silent so it is not working, or we can induce changes to make the hemoglobin production now normal. Gene therapy, it is a process. First phase is the collection of the stem cell. We will collect your own producing cells. Then, in the second phase, the company outside your body will be able to modify these stem cells, and that can take months until they are ready. When they are ready, we will admit the patient to the hospital. It will start with the given chemotherapy to remove the unhealthy cells and create space for the new modified stem cells. The cells will be infused in the vein. It will look like just simple blood transfusion, but those are magic cells that they really are gonna go through your vein to the bone marrow niche, and they start to build homes to be able to produce normally functioning cells. It will take weeks until you are able to recover from the effect of chemotherapy and that the cells are now producing normal cells. Because gene therapy targets the production of normal hemoglobin in red blood cells, it has the potential to provide functional cure for patients with thalassemia and in sickle cell. For example, in thalassemia, the studies show in both gene addition and gene editing, high percentage of them, they were transfusion free on a persistent and long term. In sickle cell disease, the studies also show a very high percentage of the patient that they were pain-free, no hospitalization for more than 2 years for many of these patients who received gene therapy. This is a very important question. There are major differences between both of them. First and foremost, gene therapy is your own stem cell. The traditional bone marrow transplant uses someone different, whether that it is your brother, sister, or someone unrelated, it's a different person. And that would lead to the second difference, the need for immune suppression. In gene therapy, it is your own cells. There is no rejection. In traditional bone marrow transplant, to prevent rejection and to prevent graft versus host disease, you do need immune suppression, usually for 6 to 9 months. Gene therapy, similar to any other innovative therapy, can have side effects. And that's why it's so important for every patient to be evaluated by a specialized center. This side effect can range from limited reversible effect that we expect, like mucositis, or increased risk of infection due to the low blood count, to more long-term side effects that are possible, like increased risk of secondary cancer due to the chemotherapy effect, and the increased risk of infertility also related to the chemotherapy. Gene therapy, it is a complicated process that could have some serious side effects, so it's important to seek an authorized center or qualified transplant center in gene editing or addition. And I am so proud to have our team at bone marrow transplant at Cleveland Clinic being authorized and qualified for this gene therapy.